What up, you guys? This is Crow here from Crow's Archery and Motorcycle Adventures. And before we jump into this topic, go ahead and like, share, comment, subscribe, hit the little bell notification in whichever corner that you find it in to be notified of me uploading more videos. So, this topic is what I like to call, let those who broke it fix it. Okay? And where this is stemming from is actually an email I received from a woman about how she's going through it with a breakup and all of that. And she wants to, she was kind of, in the email she was talking about and asking me about, you know, not contacting them and all of that and using it as an ability to maybe make another person come back. And so I really felt it was important to talk about that, honestly. And while I'm doing that, I'm going to be cleaning my sword. I need to do that and hit it with this leather strop, you know, just to polish the blade up and get it to where it's real nice and sharp. But anyway, so this is what I'm going to say about all that. So this woman, you know, going through her breakup and all of that, she was asking me about, you know, basically doing the whole thing where you just don't talk to them for 30 days, 60 days, whatever, and then, you know, reach out or make them reach out to you. Here's the thing about no contact. No contact is not a game. It's not a game that you put a time period on and be like, oh, well, after 30 days or 60 days, I'll reach back out to them or, you know, and try again. You see, the thing is, a lot of people use that as a manipulation tactic trying to get their ex or past person reinterested in them out of, you know, basically manipulating time by removing their presence. Well, here's the thing. So, if that man broke up with you, that means that it is his job to approach you again and talk to you if he wants to either fix the relationship or start a friendship or whatever. And so in that point, you allow people to him to fix what he broke, aka communication and contact. But here's the flip side of the coin, and what you really need to be more worried about and focused on, and what really you're doing. So when you're not contacting someone or chasing after someone, while yes, it's true that you're communicating that, oh well, I'm just removing my presence, that time is actually for you to be working on yourself, for yourself, not for anybody else, not for him, you know, because, I mean, he's, let it be known, he's gone. And you got to remember, when somebody's doing that to you, even if, you know, even if you didn't necessarily do anything wrong, per se, the one thing that you have to remember is, in a sense, they are telling you that they are leaving you because they believe that there is someone better than you for them out there, okay? And if you continue to chase after them, then you are communicating to them that you basically have no boundaries and that they can treat you whatever type of way and you're just going to accept it. The problem there then turns all of it into a game. And, you know, the thing is, love and loyalty are more than just quotes and tattoos and games. It's not a game, dude. You got to understand that this is the moment in time where you have to fix what you have broken, aka yourself. Because I'm sure that you were given a list of things that you could do or, you know, that they wish that you would have done or changed or whatever. And here's the thing. While yes, it's true that there are plenty of times that someone can say those things and it's just surface level of really what is going on, And I'm not saying that you should take everyone's word at, you know, at heart in that regard, but you don't need to fully dismiss what they're saying, because the thing is, they just because they're, you know, they leave you does not mean that they don't care about you. You know what I mean? It means that they just feel that you guys are not good together anymore, and that's okay. It sucks. But every time you go out there and you're chasing after somebody that's left you, you are also being very selfish. Because if you sit there and chase after them and break no contact and not allow him to fix what it was that he broke, then you're basically saying that you don't care about what he wants or needs. And that's another thing that he's going to sit there and remember. You know, you got to be out of his space. You got to let him come to his own conclusions and own decisions based on him living his life. But here's the other part of that too. You have to remember that if you genuinely care about this person, then you are going to let them go. And if, only if, they are the ones who reach out to you, then you can go from there. But until then, no. Now, it's one thing if you were the one who actually caused the, you know, actually were seriously causing problems that really did lead to the separation that you guys had, then it's one thing for you to come forward and admit your responsibility. But you, that's a conversation that should be saved for whenever they're the ones that come forward trying to engage you again. And you got to remember too that it's not, when I say it's not a game, that also means that this is not to be, this is not one of those things that needs to turn into this toxic cycle of on again, off again, on again, off again. That's toxic. It's terrible. It's bad. It's just horrible. And, you know, the when it boils down to it, in fact, I'll use an example. All right. The last girl I was seeing, she at one point told me that I was overwhelming, and that was her reasoning of stepping away from the connection that we had. And yes, it is true that we did have an awesome and amazing connection, and there was a lot of potential. The problem was, in that moment, you know, I thought it was ridiculous. How am I overwhelming? What am I doing? Until I realized the most important thing I could learn from them. And this is where you have to really work on yourself and work on self-awareness, because until you do that, you're going to be repeating the same mistakes over and over again. So when she told me that, you know, in the moment, I was just like, this doesn't even make sense. But later on, after enough time has passed, I've gotten to this point to where I realized that, yes, we talked a lot, and I did initiate a lot of conversation and did make messages super long, because on my side, while yes, I was just trying to get thoughts out that have been repressed so much over the years, you got to think, I'm a single guy with no kids, and everything I have is my own based on the work that I've done. And because of that, that's a lot of being isolated by yourself doing your thing. But the problem with that was, is that once that started to come out, it could have given her the illusion that what I was doing was basically giving all of my attention to this one area of my life, aka the quote unquote, I'm not going to say like relationship, because we weren't like together or anything, but there, the path was starting towards it. And I did focus a lot of my attention on her, but the problem with that is that if that would have gone on in the way that it was going on, then all of my attention would have been focused on her, meaning that everything else in my life would have slowly started to break down, because I wasn't going to continue giving it enough of my attention. And thinking of it like that, I realized that that was something that I broke or did wrong in that encounter with that woman. And so it is my responsibility to work on that issue myself, by myself, for myself, not for her, but for me. Because if I didn't do it for me and I wasn't actively doing what it is that I've got to do in order to overcome that, you know, behavior, then if I was to ever see her again and we start something up, then it would end up being the same thing. And that's not cool. You know, that's not cool at all. And if I was to sit there and chase after her, then I would tell her, indirectly, I'd be telling her, I don't care what you want, this is about me. And that's selfish. And that's not who I am. And that's what you would end up looking like if you go running off and trying to continuously fix something that you cannot fix. Only they can. The only thing that you can fix are the behaviors that you have within yourself and working on yourself. And so that's why it's so important that you let people fix what they broke, including yourself. You fix yourself. You fix what you broke, and that's yourself. Now, other than that, the only time I would ever break no contact is if it was literally a life or death situation concerning them. But even then, it'd still feel a little awkward, but, you know, it is what it is. But unless it's that, which it's not, 99.9% of the time, that's not how it is. You're wanting to break no contact and reach out because it is this feeling of connection, like you're still connected in some way. But the thing is, always remember this. The more that you're chasing after something or someone, the more it's going to run away from you. But the second that you stop chasing them, there's nothing left for them to run away from. So at this point, if you're working on yourself and all of that, and they hopefully would be doing the same thing, then you're both going to end up coming together. But you cannot let your relationships get stuck in this push-pull dynamic. It's bad, it's unhealthy, and it'll just keep repeating itself every single time in any other future relationship that you have because you haven't addressed the issue that you have within yourself. And so I'm going to end it with this. If you truly love someone, then that means that you are willing to let them go, walk away, and you give them what it is that they're asking for, aka being gone or at space or whatever. And in time, it is up to the dumper to approach you, not the other way around. However, this is not about ego or pride or anything or any gain. This is about principle and honor and integrity and doing the right thing because it's the right thing to do, not because you expect a certain result. All right? So if you need any more help or you need to talk about it, you know how to get a hold of me. Either way, I love all of you.